Hope you like dark roast. Sadly, that coffee hasn't seen the light of day in 5 to 10 years.
The voicemail that was left on your phone was untraceable. You started to monitor it now in case they called back.
Nunez and his men were after something that you have. It's what they were looking for at Jennifer's house.
Your editor said you were working on a story on white-collar crime. Would you follow the wrong lead?
2 months ago, I was contacted by a source inside the Panamanian government. Said he had some files for me.
What kind of files?
Contracts, bank records, emails, you name it. These records contain the names of people all around the globe who were anonymously hiding millions of dollars in fake corporations throughout Panama.
Shell corporations, perfect for money laundering, tax evasion, and funding terrorist activities.
You were gonna publish the names of the real owners of these companies, revealing their true identity?
You ever heard of the Mossack Fonseca papers? This is like that, only bigger. The information I have would pull back the curtain on every person routing money throughout Panama to hide their corruption.
These companies are a major source of revenue for Panama. If their confidentiality is called into question, every bank and law firm will take a huge financial hit.
Which is why they hired these guys to get you before you published your article.
That's why they're holding Jennifer as a bargaining chip until they do. Excuse us.
Laurel and Hardy aren't talking.
If they don't get Jenkins' files and stop him from writing that article, Jennifer's as good as dead.
Millions of dollars in dirty money tied to some of the world's most powerful people. This is bigger than we thought.
It is, Ms. Kolchek. But Jennifer is still our primary concern for now.
What are you thinking, Eddie?
Flick the lights, gentlemen. It's time to bring in the audience.